Friends, today we are going to use Tinkercad, Canva, and our Bambu Labs printers to make an awesome 3D printable sign. So let's get cracking. All right, friends, let me show you just how quickly we can build this. Obviously, this is Tinkercad, but step one is going to happen in Canva. Of course, you need to visit canva.com. I choose sign in with Google. Today we're going to create a 3D design, and I always use the square Instagram post. We need text, so we can click and add a text box. My words are going to be HL, press enter, Modtech. I do want the HL and the M and the T capitalized. I also want them moved to the left. I can switch that by just clicking right here. Notice I do need to click somewhere else and get it ready to swap the alignment. I also want to pick a fun font for this project. When you click on the text fonts, there are so many to pick from. Find one that you think is awesome. You can have fun scrolling through them. You can also check the different styles. I am just going to use the Shrikhand. When you're happy with the font you chose, you can adjust the size, but you do want to adjust the line spacing. We need them to almost connect. We can leave a little gap, but we need to have them super close. Once you've got that, you could click File and you could download it. I prefer instead to use my screen capture tool. I've got a shortcut so I can simply grab it, select it, and then in Snagit, which I have purchased, I can do file export, and after a few clicks, bingo, we've got the file and we're ready to move on. The second thing we're going to use is a website called PicSVG. We're going to simply upload that image that we just saved a moment ago. We do need to switch to what's called an internal choice though. This gives us the type of SVG we want. When you hit download SVG, I'm going to put mine in my downloads. As you can see, I've already made that name once. This time, I'm going to add a 2, and I'm going to hit save. Just like that, we can enter Tinkercad. As you can see, I've changed mine to HL sign, and we're going to choose import to bring in that part, to bring in that SVG we just created. Notice we want the art, and then I'm only going to make this 120 millimeters long. Notice when I type that, it automatically adjusts the other, and I can simply hit import. Bingo, it arrives just like that. Now we're going to turn on a special effect called outer line. I'm going to tell you the first number I want to try is 3 to see if they connect. We can adjust that if they don't. I also want to make it round, and I want to upgrade the quality of the shape. Now, as you can see, 3 does connect, so that will work. If you wanted to try a larger number, you can. I do want to make it a little bit longer, so I'm going to stretch it just like that. All right, so with that in place, I am just going to pick a different blue because I think it's fun. And then we are going to do Control D to duplicate. We're going to take the second one, and we're going to make it a silhouette. You do need to wait a moment for it to become real. So to line this up, we're going to use W for work plane, click on the edge, click on that silhouette, do D to drop. Now I am choosing to make this 1.2 millimeters thick. That's about 4 layers. So if I click control down arrow, that's 1, that's 2 millimeters. So it's sunk in. I'm actually going to go 3 millimeters. I think that'll look even a little cooler. Now I'm going to click on it and let's pick a different color. I'm going to switch back to presets and I'm going to make it white just like the one we're looking at. I'm also going to do W for work plane so that looks better. Hopefully you notice that we're missing the inside of the letters. Now we could do a lot of work to delete these edges and actually have the real letters. Check it out though, we really don't have to. I think it looks just as cool if we cruise a cylinder out, put it on the white spot. Of course, pick the right color. Check out this trick. If we click on the custom color, click the color number, and click the shape, it immediately grabs that color. I'm going to take the sides and maximize them, and let's do squeeze with these handles until we've got the right shape. Shrink it down to the right height. I'm going to scroll in my zoom a little bit, make sure I'm looking at it from the top, and get the exact angle and size that I think looks cool. Just like that, we've got it lined up. Now we need to make that height match. To get that height lined up, I'm going to simply drop it down to 1.6 and press enter. And I am happy with that. Of course, you could turn on the micro nudge and get it exactly how you want it. once you're happy with the O, you can do Control D and Shift Nudge to move it over to the D. Once again, use the handles to adjust and twist until you have the exact style you want. And then once again, Control D. This time I'm going to drag it over, rotate it so that it fits, and use those black handles to get it exactly how I want. Note if you use the white handles, it does both X and Y at the same time. That is why I choose the black handles. Let's quickly add one more final touch. You notice the back is not there. We're going to add that by simply selecting the outside, doing Control D, and then taking that shape and making it a silhouette. Notice it's super tall. We're going to switch that to 1.2 millimeters. Once again, at 0.3 layers, that gets us 4 layers. Now it is filled in, and we're ready for exporting. Once again, select it all, choose export. Notice we only have the 6 shapes, and we're going to choose an STL. I save it in my 3D modeling folder, and let's give it the name, HL Sign 3, and save those changes. Friends, we're going to be printing with the Bambu Labs P1S, and we're going to use the awesome color-changing filament from Polar Filament. So a user mentioned this looked like cardboard, which is not recommended by Bambu Labs. It is not cardboard. It is a composite and it's got burnished ends. So that way it works absolutely awesome. Friends, now we can move to Bambu Studio. I'm gonna create a brand new project and let's bring in that sign. All right, so it says that it's having issues with some edges. I'm gonna hit repair and let it do its work. Note that only takes a few seconds, says it's good. I don't see anything that's going to bug me. Of course, I did update Filament a minute ago, so I want to make sure that my AMS is synchronized. If I hit resync, you can see that now that I have my PLA basic, and it is the white. I also want to show you this. We can right-click on our objects and choose the color. I'm going to print this with the PLA white, and then I'm going to use the paint technique to fill it in. Once again, we click paint, we choose fill, and you pick your color. I want to paint the insides, so you can just click and get those all filled in just a few moments. Bang. Today I'm going to choose to print draft quality, so it's a little bit faster. I'm going to discard that value and I'm going to do it in front of you. I am going to shut off the prime tower. That just makes it a little quicker, and I think these are going to turn out absolutely awesome anyhow. And now we're ready to slice it and print it. Notice the awesome white is loaded and that sweet color change in PLA from Polar Filament is loaded. And now we can click send and download it to the printer. Don't forget you can always hit the play button. And after a moment, you'll be able to monitor progress from wherever you're at. And here we are, friends, with the HLModTech stand-up sign. Easily pop it off the bed, and you may notice it's all one color. Friends, this is my favorite part. If you look closely, you can definitely see there are two kinds of filament. Friends, here's the secret of magic color filament. As you can see, I have got a bag of ice, and what is happening is as that filament cools, we get to see the color blue. That is the way the Polar Filament Magic Color works. How cool is that? It will become stable on its own, but of course, I'm in a hurry to create the video, and I just wanted you to see how absolutely awesome it can turn out. And there she is, friends. How cool is that? Friends, as I wrap up, I do want to remind you about my website, hlmodtech.com. Of course, I've got the page dedicated to Tinkercad with tons of amazing categories. Below that, you'll find the day one favorites, the useful starters, and the Tinkercad essentials. If you scroll down just a little bit more, you will find my course, Tinkercad in 20 Days. It is hosted on cadclass.org. If you check this video, it explains all about it, and if you check the bottom, you will find a coupon code 25HLTinkercad. It will get you 25% off any course on the site. Of course, you can visit the site by simply clicking the link. Friends, of course, I do want to remind you about the sweet built-in messaging tool. You can click that button, add your question, comment, or suggestion, and reach me almost instantly. I also want to highlight the Tinkercad community Discord. As you can see, there are a boatload of members, and it is a fantastic place to talk everything Tinkercad. Finally, friends, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Please also hit that share button so more people can learn about HLModTech. Don't forget, you absolutely make my day if you take time to leave a comment down below. And if you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button. And last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HLModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.